My name is Akisanya Soni Ajose. I was born in Badagry. I schooled here in Lagos at Tinubu Methodist School. And at my cradled age, I was living in Taiwo, Ulowo, in Lagos Island. My father insisted that I must go to school in Badagry because he wanted me to have a feel of what the rural setting is. In those days, there was no direct route to Badagry. We had to transverse through old Abeokuta Road to Songuota towards Adodo before coming back towards Badagry. At that point, I was living in King George Avenue, which is now Herbert Macaulay. King George Avenue is just by Casino Cinema. In those days, there is nothing like video, there is nothing like these televisions that we are used to now, until the Western region established the television system. In 1966, May, they conceived an idea of creating Lagos State as it is today. It was then that they brought the then Major Obalaji Johnson, who is now a retired Brigadier General, from the Midwest to come to Lagos on an assignment as an administrator of the capital city of Lagos. In 1979, Alhaji Latif Jagunde came on board. He came in with a different set mind, possibly because of his interaction with the then Western Region government under the leadership of Papa Chief Awolowo. He has so many types of programs towards education, housing, environment. And in the area of education, at that particular time, we are running three shifts. Some people will go in the morning, children will go in the afternoon, and also in the evening. So he found that very, very complex and said, okay, I think it's time that we should try to bring one system of class sessions in place. So he decided to acquire some lands and start building the, what the people call it then, poultry sheds. But poultry sheds was the foundation for all the benefits that we are now enjoying in terms of education infrastructure in this state. Mudashiru came later to start building on what Baja Kande left behind. Ashu Ajibola Ahmed Tinubu also went to do a model Millennium Schools, which absorbed so many other children for ease of accommodation for the school's children. I would say that Lagos has been very, very lucky to have committed people with vision, with determination, and with zeal to make sure that they provide quality service for the people. Lagos is a melting pot for every Nigerian. A melting pot in the sense that it accommodates all. Different cultural groups have settled here, and they were received with open arms by the citizens or indigents of this state. And you will also see that in every aspect of economic development, Lagos has always been a leading point. We have been an example for majority of governments through our policy drives in this state. That is why everything we do here is also being copied by the majority of other states. They come directly here to learn. How do you do it? And we don't hide it because we want to extend our ideas to other states so that they can benefit, and then we can have a nation that is strong and varied.
Come and see you, Tao Pekowe. Pekowe, oh, come and see you, Tao Pekowe.
This is my Lagos story.